When in silence is heard a distant but familiar voice.
Mary!
Wait, it's Bat! Here, Molly, you can't see. It's only a bit of fun.
Have withdrawn to respectful distance, but are watching the proceedings, still wondering if they could find a way to have their chance. Rat, catching sight of them, puts bait to that idea.
Don't eat them!
Start on that more serious business.
winter business.
Yes, of course.
Right. Here's me little blanket for you, Rat. Oh, and here's a nice big comfortable duvet for you, Mooley.
Next morning sees Badger serving some very adhesive porridge to two small hedgehogs, Tommy and Billy.
Oh, I've got some piping hot porridge here, right for you both. Oh, we got rats in the house. Excuse me. Oh, here's a nice big wee spoonful of porridge. For my wee little Tommy. There we go.
Thank you, sir.
And a nice big spoonful for Billy. There we go.
Thank you, sir.
Oh, now knit it all up there. There's a good kids for you. There, right. I'm just going off into my study to deal with the correspondence. Oh, right. Let's get rid of them.
Rat, who has plainly had a less comfortable night, edges painfully off the floor. Mole, who has slept much better, of course, not only because he has been in a comfortable chair, but because being underground suits him. Tommy stands up and pulls Billy to his feet.
Motor cars are progress, sir. Motor cars are the future.
right, not the toads. Well, Mr. Parkinson, please remove this infernal combustion engine.
Mr. Parkinson, who is not used to having his customers kidnapped, goes off the top with the Toad, who has given his captors the slip, comes frantically in pursuit.
Toad! Come back here this instant. Toad, you have been squandering the money that your father left you, giving us animals a bad name into the bargain. Now take off those ridiculous clothes.
Shut up! Shut up! Shut up! Shut up!
Then we shall use force. A prisoner toad in your own home until you give me where you be promised. And although you don't deserve it, one of your friends will guard you.
I shall take the last horse.
Shh. Come now, toad. You promise?
Sharp! White! Poop! Poop!
Don't be rude, toad!
And I'll take a second. Oh, do come on, toad. It's just a promise, that's all.
Carl wouldn't not ever.
Completely mad. He was determined to get a motor car, even if he had to beg, borrow, or...
Well, how do you like her, Monica?
Like her? Rupert, I love her.
Peggy's?
I'll say, this motoring lot really gives a girl an appetite.
What do you say we adjourn to yonder hostelry so that my host can offer in the way of fodder?
What a topping idea!
Give the old girl time to cool off, eh?
But I know this car. It's the one Badger had sent away.
Should I go for a drive?
No, that would be silly.
Just a little drive, perhaps.
While they're having their lunch, it will be very naughty. I'll just see if it starts into the...
Toad, having started the engine, releases the handbrake, depresses the clutch, puts the car in gear, gently easing his foot off the clutch and giving a touch of accelerator, slowly moves off. Purists and driving instructors would have noted that he omitted to check his driving mirror and to give the signal, I am moving off. But after all, this is the first motor car he has driven in several months, and it is an exciting moment. It is so exciting, in fact, that he throws caution to the wind, goes faster and faster, and suddenly, I wasn't following a hedgehog, he drives into a pond.
Oh,
glasses with a charming home in the Riverside setting. Date back to the 14th century. And moreover, I understand he regularly sits down to meals of at least 5 courses. Some might think that this is the clincher. He never has to do his own washing up!
Yes, I've never done washing up before in my life.
I'm glad to hear it. Now that is one side of the picture. The other may not detain us here long. Now the prisoner is accused of taking and driving away a motor car. Apropos of which, I would like to ask the court one question. Why would the prisoner, a person of means, steal a motor car when he can, as we have heard, just as easily borrow
it? Why should he buy one when he can just as easily steal one?
Sufficiently hot for the hardened criminal and incorrigible
now, cowering in the dock.
Before I... In your honour, he's not cowering.
Now. Thank you. That was very publicly spirited of you. Now, what is the stiffest penalty we can give for stealing a motor car?
Ah, yes. 12 months. Wages in you.
Oh, I hope to give him something longer than that.
Yeah, well, you can't, Rick, no.
What did the prince say?
Big news, Your Honour.
Would I think that?
Not especially.
So it's not a fair comment?
No, cheap.
Can I give him anything for that?
Oh, yes. 20 years. Oh,
excellent. That cheered me up to no end. 20 years. Take that.
Toad's disgrace rocked the nation. It seemed the dwarves were determined to make an example of him. Of course, his friends tried to help him, but they were blocked at every turn. Why, they must have reopened the case a dozen times. They appealed to this court, that court, any court. But the decision stood. The case of J. Thaddeus Toad was closed. Yes, once again it was a white Christmas, and once again the melodies of Yuletide hung sweet upon the winter's air. Hearts were gay and spirits high. Indeed, in all over the city, there was but one spot untouched by the spirit of Christmas. The tower. Grim monument to despair. Cruel. The moon. And unfortunately, the abode of Mr. J. Thaddeus Toad. And there were many Christmases yet to come. Poor Toad, alone with the memories of his wasted life. Oh, what a fool he had been. Within the confines of this miserable cell, the new Toad was born again. Transformed Toad, repentant Toad. Never again would he let his mad, foolish misdemeanors have brought him to the sorry.
Couldn't I be a lady novelist?
Oh, Bring out your washing!
Say, how'd you like to earn some money?
Ooh,
not bad. Give me the money.
Oh, yes, of course. Here we are, right.
There is a distant resemblance. Here, my sisters.
Say, there you go.
Noah, undress.
Yeah.
You're on a married woman.
Are you stupid? You've had your money.
Oh, I'll see. That's it, is it? Now you've been paid. Take your clothes off.
Woman, what has the world come to? Huh.
Oh, no.
There you go, Mr. Sully. Now, Grandma wouldn't forget her little Tony boy, now, would she?
Cyril? Oh, Cyril.
Look, it's a Christmas gift.
Oh, what is it?
Don't you get it? It's a disguise. Now, all you have to put this little dress on,
yes,
and then we can...